Guys, welcome back to my channel. I am Sandhya and I'm a travel vlogger and this is my Kolkata episode 2. And in case if you have not watched my Kolkata episode 1, go ahead and watch right now. I'm going to leave the link in the description below. So in this episode, I have covered the rest of the places that you should see while you're in Kolkata and also some of the yummiest places that you can have food while you're there. So stay tuned for it and come along with me. Victoria Memorial right now, and it's early as 6 a.m. in the morning. So this is a very famous landmark in Kolkata, and everyone who visits Kolkata will come to this place because this building is gorgeous to look at. So this building is around 115 years old and is built by pure marble in the memory of Queen Victoria. So if you are a photographer and if you want to take a very cool pictures, you should come early morning to take a good background pictures. But if you want to see the museum inside, then you should come between 11 to 5 and the ticket is 30 rupees. But if you just want to walk around in the garden, it's 20 rupees and the garden opens as early as 6 a.m. And also in the evening, you have a sound and light show. And I heard it is gorgeous. So I'm going to walk around this place, get the vibe of it, and take some cool pictures, and I'll then head back. You make me nervous. I think I might be hooked on you. I love the things you said to me. It seems like you like me too. We can take it slow, make sure we do this right. Canceled all my plans to be with you tonight. So guys, if you're in Kolkata and at least for 10-15 minutes you want to feel the royal vibe, you must come to Victoria Memorial. And just outside Victoria Memorial, you have these beautifully decorated chariots, and they charge around 400 to 500 rupees for 10 to 15 minutes, and then they'll take you around this beautiful spin. I suggest you come in the evenings or early mornings because it's the breeze and the whole vibe of it and the amber sunset, everything makes this ride all the more special. I am feeling very royal now, so hence I am waving the Queen Victoria wave. Bye. So guys, I'm done with the shoot now, and before I head out, I really want to meet my friend. He's Masood. I met him in Samsung event. Hi Masood.
Hi.
So what's your Instagram handle? Tell them.
Photostick Life.
So if you really want to follow a very good portrait photography and street photography profile, go ahead and check his Instagram profile.
Thank you.
Is Photostick Life. I will ping here. Now where are we going next?
We are going to Prince Edward now.
I am on the boat in Prince Edward Ghat, and this river what you see is Hooghly River. So if you want to hire a boat like this, it costs around 300 rupees. So people come here for morning walking, you know, it's a beautiful park around this river. And I'm going to explore this place around, and then I'm going to head back. Market in Calcutta, which is also known as New Market. So this market is more than 115 years old with over 2,000 shops to shop around, and some of the shops are as old as 100 years old. So if you are in Calcutta, and you must visit this heritage site to witness the true charm of Kolkata through its colonial architecture. And also you will be spoiled for choice. You can shop what all you want, like accessories, clothes, shoes, eat in some vintage bakeries and a lot more. I am going to spend spend a lot of time exploring this place. And there is one pro tip: you must bargain. While I suck at bargaining, bargaining works here. Second thing is you should not come in your own car because parking is very difficult. Third thing, wear comfortable shoes because you'll be doing a lot of walking around. So I'm going to explore and I'll see you guys. So guys, if you're in Hogs Market, you should come to this bakery. So it is called Nahum's and it is a 115-year-old Jewish bakery. And people have been eating in this bakery for generations together. And the moment you walk into this bakery, you'll be amazed and mesmerized the kind of smell you get from the freshly baked products here. So I am trying this lemon puff here, but you are spoiled for choice because they make amazing varieties of bakery products, be it bread, cakes, brownies, etc. So I'm going to try different things here before I head for the shopping.
राजू समतानी है।
ये कितना पुराना है?
About 50 years old shop. From my father's time we are running this shop.
Okay.
And now I'm again giving training to my son. Now he will take over the business.
This is a generation shop.
You're the third generation.
Yeah,
yes.
I'm the third generation.
Okay. So I heard that some shops are more than 100 years old here.
It is Zaya Raman company, that is the oldest shop in the new market. Lal Chand, Dhala Mals, Kavita, B. Moti Ram.
Okay.
Yeah, those are very, very old shops.
Okay. So guys, I am at this shop which is called Chamba Lamba. This is a very old shop and quite famous for its pure silver jewelry. So if you are in Hogs Market, you should come and check this place, especially if you are a sucker for silver jewelry. So I'm going to go inside and check out some cool silver jewelry now. So guys, I had amazing time exploring Hogs Market. It's super fun to explore and you will be spoiled for choice for different kinds of shops you will get here. And I really love the silver jewelry collection here. Now I am signing off from Hogs Market. Next pit stop is this 50-year-old Kati Rolls place. Supposedly this place has invented Kati Rolls in Kolkata, and this place serves a huge variety of Kati Rolls, be it mutton, fish, double mutton, chicken, and also the egg rolls. So the roll what you see is a chicken and mutton mixed roll, and I'm going to have one bite with this and I'm going to eat mirchi because I really really like spicy food. So this is my first bite into this very popular Kati Roll. Have you been to the oldest museum in India? This is the oldest museum in India. This is the Indian Museum of Calcutta. And this is also the 9th oldest museum in the world. So the entry ticket is 50 rupees per head for adults. And if you're getting a DSLR or a phone for photography, then you have to pay 100 rupees more. And the timings is 10 to 5. It's to be believed they have the oldest fossils, as old as 1300 BC or more. So I'm going to walk around this museum and I'm going to explore. First of all, this museum infrastructure is super, super nice. I love the huge colonial corridors and everything. So you have to spend considerably 2 hours of time to explore every nook and corner of this museum. Thank you. Kolkata and you have not eaten biryani, that will be a big crime, because Kolkata is also famous for its famous mutton biryani. And my pick would be Arsalan, because you will get amazing, delicious biryani. It has both the influence of Mughal and Indian spices. And also, don't be surprised if you find aloo in the biryani, because Bengalis are obsessed with aloo. And this is the one of the most delicious aloo you'll ever eat in biryani, because all the spices, all the masalas and all the gravy of biryani gets soaked into aloo, which makes it really, really delicious. So I'm going to go inside and enjoy the biryani tonight. So guys, as expected, the taste has never changed. So I get the same taste like how I ate 2 years back when I come here. And the mutton is so cooked to perfection, it just falls off the bone. I don't even have to use a knife or a fork. And there's also one more delicacy that you should try. It's called mutton gazala, and it's very famous in Kolkata, and I had it in the Kolkata wedding. It is yum. So in case if you're watching the video till now, I think you should start subscribing, like and comment my video. So I'm going to eat all this biryani and then head home. Right. So guys, this is the end of my Kolkata vlog series, and in case if you really enjoy my content and really want to help me grow, don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Also give this video a thumbs up, comment if you have any questions, and also share this video with your family and friends. So also stay tuned for my next series, which is Sikkim series. So I'll be touring Sikkim for the whole 1 month. I'll be covering East, West, North and South Sikkim, and make sure you catch up on the series too. I'm going to see you in my next series. Bye bye.